Hello students, so today I'm going to narrate you the third part of the story, A Season of No Return. So far you have studied this story step by step. The first part was in the morning scene, second part was related with nostalgic feeling. And now we are going to read evening scene in two parts. So let's see what happens with Kauri and how her mental life is reflected in the story. So I will read out, listen to it carefully and try to go through the states of her mind. It begins with reference to her thoughts that are coming in her mind. She had been walking around in a daze until she saw the maid coming in. And that is when she felt somewhat relieved. For the past few days, even the maid had not appeared to be in her usual frame of mind, as she had been going about her work in a rather slipshod manner. Very rarely would she discuss her family matters, as she would often rush through her work and push off in a hurry. As it is, she had spread her net so wide that she hardly ever had any time. So in this stanza, here she means Kauri. And what she think of maid is narrated in this paragraph. The maid is woman who works in houses, in homes. And for last few days, Kauri finds that she is not talking to her as usual, as if somebody has told her not to talk too long with Kauri. So when she comes, she does her work fast and quickly goes off. So Kauri watches her. Since till the afternoon, she had nobody to spend her time with. See, Kauri waits for her. So maid is in the beginning days used to talk with her about her family, about her husband and children, etc. But now even the maid keeps quiet, and that is surprising to Kauri. Often while sweeping the floors or washing the dishes or dusting the tables, when she would suddenly break into a conversation, Kauri invariably found it difficult to tune into her gibberish. And so would keep nodding her head, repeating, "All right, all right." As soon as she nodded affirmation, a sudden feeling of peace descended upon her. She wanted to help her out so that after finishing her work in a good time, the maid could sit and talk with her. Both of them might be able to share their joys and sorrows. Perhaps it was the daughter-in-law again who had tutored the maid, for she to never allowed her to do a thing. Preventing her from doing the work, she would screech in Hindi, "Maji, why do you want to deprive me of my livelihood?" So here in this paragraph, it is very clear, because the maid says to Kauri that If I go on talking and wasting my time in this way, I may lose my job. And that instruction may be given by Kauri's daughter-in-law, as she would have found her talking with Maji, that is Kauri, for a long time and exchanging her feelings and thoughts. It may be related with the daughter-in-law. So here we see that the relation between Kauri and maid are traced here. Initially, Kauri used to dislike her immensely. Then she got to know of her problems. She was mother of 5 children. Her husband worked as a coolie at the station. As he squandered all his earnings upon himself, would not even give a counterfeit coin at home. So she had to earn to provide her children. Now Kauri had even begun to sympathize with her. So changing relation between Kauri and the maid are described here. So initially, in the beginning, Kauri did not like her because she used to talk a lot, her gibberish talk and complaining attitude, cursing attitude. Maybe it was not liked by Kauri. But when she realized, Kauri realized that she is really in problem. Her husband is not okay. He is a coolie and does not give a rupee to spend our household work, and how poor she is and miserable her condition is. When she comes to know this about the maid, she even began to have sympathy over her. But until today, she had not spoken to the maid properly. As soon as the maid left, Kakka woke up. She bruised herself with his feet. After the feed, when he became engrossed with his own games, she began to heat up her food. Once she had finished her meals, it suddenly occurred to her that Kakka was already late for his bath. Giving him a hurried bath, she changed his clothes and washed the old ones as well. In the meanwhile, it was already 3 o'clock. She gave him another feed, on finishing which he went off to sleep. So you see in this paragraph that in the afternoon, it is only Kauri who looks after Kakka, feeding him twice, changing his clothes, washing him, taking care of him, and even make him sleep. All these household chores duties she performs in this way. Overwhelmed by a feeling of emptiness within, Kauri came out into the veranda and sat down there. So after doing all these her duties towards the Kakka, you see the mind of Kauri is opened here. A feeling of emptiness is there within her mind. And when Kakka goes to sleep, she comes into veranda and sat down there alone, and a feeling of emptiness arises in her mind. Having returned from their schools, the children of Gujarati, Bengali, Madrasi families were now busy playing, making noises out in the ground. For a while, at least, she did like their commotion, but soon enough, she began to get rather impatient with it. Walking in, she felt as though sweat had soaked her down to the skin. It occurred to her that she had had her bath today. Though she did feel like having a bath, yet somehow she couldn't muster enough strength to walk up to the bathroom. So, as I told you that she has come to live in a city which is quite a metropolitan city, and where families across India come for work, and they live together in the buildings like the skyscrapers like apartments, and you see the cosmopolitan atmosphere is there, and which is rather not familiar to Kauri. So here you see that the children of Gujarati family, Bengali family, Madrasi families are there. In the afternoon they make a lot of noise, play ground is there. And initially Kauri did like it, but later it was rather beyond her patience to bear them all. So these things are around there. That very moment she heard the sound of auto rickshaw outside. After a while the darling daughter-in-law walked in, her purse dangling across her arms. Flashing a smile in her customary manner, she said, "Maji, pranam," and then darted a glance towards Kaka. Then she shot the same old question, "Did she have his milk properly?" The moment Kauri said yes, she rushed straight into bathroom. After a while, when she came out, looking at Kauri in a surprised manner, she asked, "Did you have your bath today? You haven't combed your hair. Go and have your bath. How hot it is." So, this is a routine. In the afternoon, say here, you see that rickshaw comes, and out of the rickshaw, her daughter-in-law gets off, and she immediately comes to her flat. All those things she asks about the kakka, whether his slave taken his foods and milks properly, etc., etc. So all these things are typical routine mechanical you see, and of which Kauri has now fed up with. So you see here, even this her talking of daughter-in-law, Kauri found it customary. They are regularly manner, the same things, the same words, the same expressions are being heard by her for such a long period, and of which Kauri has become fed up with. At last, momentarily, she was totally befuddled as to how her daughter-in-law could get to know whether or not she had her bath. She felt reassured in a rather strange way. It suddenly struck her that she should give a befitting retort, saying that she had no intentions of having a bath today. But she held her counsel quietly. She walked towards the bathroom. The darling daughter-in-law bruised herself with making tea. So she asks about her bath. She wants to Kauri retort her. Retort. याचा अर्थ होतो की प्रतिउत्तर देणे, तेवढ्याच रागाने प्रतिउत्तर देणे. बट सी डज नॉट डू दॅट. सी लिसन्स टू हर दॅट शी शुड बाथ अँड सी गोज टू टेक बाथ. कौरी गोज टू टेक बाथ, बट शी डज नॉट रिटॉर्ट टू हर डॉटर इन लॉ. बट सी वॉन्ट्स टू रिटॉर्ट. सी वॉन्ट्स टू गिव अ बी फिटिंग रिटॉर्ट. यू सी हर माइंड सेटअप हियर. At 5:30, Santokh came back as well as was his daily routine. Two or three of his friends came with him. After greeting Kauri with Sat Sri Akal, all of them walked into living room. She could constantly hear the sounds of peeling laughter and the tip-tapping of her daughter-in-law's chappals coming in from the living room. It felt as though neighbor's son was firing shots with his air gun. This was enough to make her restless all over again. So, this couple is living a typical city life. After coming home from their routine office works, the friends come together, gather together in their halls, and they go on talking, chit-chatting with each other, and all those sounds and laughter and exchanges of words are heard by Kauri inside, and she feels day by day it is all restless. She feels restless over this all again and again. So we can understand the state of her mind. At about 6:15, all of them marched out, perhaps for an evening stroll or for watching a film. She didn't ask any question. When the darling daughter-in-law came in to pick up Kaka, she did mention something about where they were going, but the constant buzz in her ears had not really allowed her to hear anything. It was perhaps the roar of 3 scooters at a time that made her heart jump into her mouth, as it were. However, once this sound had subsided, the emptiness of the house began to wrap itself around her. So you can compare the emptiness yacha marathit ardha ek pokripana yeto. So you can compare the emptiness of the house with the emptiness of her mind. So house is empty and her mind is also empty. Something is missing that she even not able to identify hurt what it is. But you see here that how at exactly about 6:15 all of them go out, perhaps for strolling, walking or film or dinner, etc. It may be whatever it may be, but they do not stop in the flat, and Kauri is given responsibility to look after the Kakka. So the kind of life they are living there is described in this scene. Thank you.